Right now we're going to combine some images in Photoshop and make this butterfly woman. Hey Cafe crew, Colin Smith here from photoshopcafe.com. Today we're going to combine these two images and it's going to help you understand layer masks and some blending modes. First thing, let's open two images. We're going to choose File, Open. And I've got this folder here where I've got a couple of images and I'm just going to choose Open. And I'll open them inside of Photoshop. Bonus tip for those of you on Big Sur, click the image and then you'll see this little icon. You can use this icon to drag and that's how you can put it into folders or different things like that, or just drop it into Photoshop. Back with everybody, let's combine the two images. So we're going to take the picture here of the woman and we're going to put it on top of the butterfly. So the way to do it is to select it, click and hold, drag up to the tab. I haven't released yet. This is very important. Go into the middle, hold down the shift key. The shift key will center it, then release your mouse button. And now we have two images, one on top of the other. To align these, we want to see both layers at the same time. A lot of people make the mistake of dropping the opacity. Let's not do that. Rather, with that layer selected, click where it says normal and go all the way down to difference. If you ever wondered what difference blending mode is for, now you know. With the top layer still selected, now we can position where we want it. If we want to make it larger, Control T, that would be Command T on Mac, opens up Free Transform. Now I want to resize it, but let's do it from the center. So hold down the Alt or the Option key, and that will enable us to resize it from the center. So drag once again to position. When you're happy with the position, hit enter. Let's go back to our normal blend mode. Now we see our face. All right, let's start blending them. The first thing we want to do is create a layer mask on this layer, but I want to hide the contents of the layer. So hold down the Alt or the Option key, click on layer mask, it hides everything. Hit the B key for brush. Just choose the simple soft round brush. Because the layer mask is black, we want to paint with white. Fastest way to get white is the foreground color. Hit the D for default, and that will reset it, give us white. Excellent. Now we're just going to paint. With that mask still selected, let's paint. Find the eyes. And let's go up to the second eye. Now the eyebrow is probably a good place where we can start to let that kind of fall off. We'll blend these better in just a moment. Let's keep going up the top. And I want to start to get the top of the head. Let's keep going until we see some hair. There we go. This could work like fur, as far as the viewer is concerned. If you want to blend these, choose the brush options. If you have a Wacom tablet, choose transfer, select pen pressure for opacity. If you don't have a Wacom tablet, just lower the opacity of your brush to somewhere around about 15%. And now you can paint and slowly start to blend this in a little bit better. Now we've got some more masking to do. And I'm going to use the butterfly for this masking. First thing we're going to do is we're going to duplicate it. Control J. And then hide the background. So now we're just looking at one copy of the butterfly. Let's hide the top as well by hitting the eye. Grab the magic wand. We want to cut out the butterfly. Click in the white area. Now we want to put this inside a layer mask. Hold down the Alt or the Option key and click, it'll hide the background. You could hit the Delete key if you wanted, but this is a better way because it's non-destructive and we can use it later. Choose the top layer once again and let's turn the background on. It gives us that nice white there. Now what we want to do is clean up the edges. We're going to use that layer mask. Control or click on that layer mask to load the selection. If you'd hit the delete key, you could do the same thing with the layer. Now choose the layer mask we want to paint on. To paint back, choose the brush again. This time hit the X key or just tap, get black for the foreground, and now we can use this to paint back. Notice I turned the opacity of the brush all the way back up. And if you go too far, just hit the X key once again, that'll toggle between black and white, and you can just kind of blend this in. Let's do the same thing down the bottom. Same mask, hit the X key, make sure we've got black, and now we can start to blend these layers together. Control D will turn off the selection. Drop the brush opacity down about 20% by tapping the 2 key. And now just gently go and finish the blending. So using these simple images, I hope this has helped you pick up a couple of new tips with layer masks inside of Photoshop. If you did, let me know in the comments underneath. And by the way, guys, if you are new here, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Consider hitting that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my tutorials. And if you got any value out of this, do me a favor, hit that like button underneath. That helps us with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe. That like button underneath helps us with the YouTube algorithm.